plans are an important part of the building design and construction process. So we want to make it as efficient and user-friendly to create them as possible. The Quickdraw, BIMWALL, and Quickwall tools have all been revamped. Let's start with the Quickdraw tool. We'll create a new site with a building and floor, and then we'll enter top view mode, which is the most convenient and user-friendly way to model. Clicking the Quickdraw tool will bring up the new panel, which is far more intuitive to use. We still have the geometry parameters, but you'll note we now also have the option to place the wall next to the floor slab or on top of the floor slab. We can start drawing a room, using the Control hotkey to toggle the justification. For the next room, we'll change the wall placement to on top of the slab and start drawing. If we change the view, we can see the difference that this user-requested option makes. Now let's head back into top view mode and check out some of the other new options available. In this case, the advanced snapping option. Check the options you want and the snapping points you want, and simply snap and drag to draw your next room. Quickdraw is great for rectangular rooms, but when you want more complicated shapes, the BIMWALL tool is there for you. The BIMWALL tool is based on the PolySolid tool, but it's been tweaked and tailored for users in the building industry. You can set the wall thickness and height, as well as the justification and offsets. You also have the option to assign a composition to the wall, which will then override the width, since it's something that has been predefined. Start drawing your wall, changing justification as you need, and using arcs and the grid to draw. The Quickwall tool also has a snazzy new interface, making it a more consistent user experience with the BIMWALL tool. New to V23.2 is the ability to create a freestanding wall. Input length, and the wall will show up on the end of your cursor, ready to be placed. As you zoom out, the tool recognizes the wall on either side and gives you the option to snap to those. Zooming into the model allows you to snap to only one wall. Since the opposite wall isn't in the view, the tool disregards it. In this case, specify a length and insert the wall. Change the wall direction using the Control hotkey and continue adding walls as you need them. Not all buildings are new. There are many buildings that need renovation or extension. In this case, it's critical to have an accurate record of the existing conditions, which is best done from point clouds. In this release, we wanted to make it a lot more efficient to create those records in BricsCAD by improving our scan to BIM workflows. Let's enter top view mode again and use the sliders to select a suitable section to work with. Using the Quickwall tool, you can set a free wall length and place walls using the point cloud as a guide. BricsCAD automatically detects wall thickness for you. Continue to place walls using Control to toggle between horizontal and vertical. And once you have some guide walls, use L Connect to connect them together and use BIM Extend to connect walls perpendicularly. If we leave top view mode, we can see our model complete with all its building elements. The way we use Invert Spaces has also been improved, with the ability to automatically recognize openings such as windows and doors. We start off by using a point cloud with bubble views. Using the Fit Planar tool, we can click on flat surfaces, walls, ceilings, floors, and using the Select Opening tool, we'll recognize doors and windows. BricsCAD BIM builds us a model with planes and polylines which represent openings. Now we can optimize the 3D model and run the Invert Spaces command. This will give us a model with floors, walls, and slabs. Use the L Connect tool to properly connect the walls to the slabs, and we can unfreeze the layer that holds our automatically created openings. Now, we can replace these with BIM elements such as windows and doors. Finally, let's show you some of the improvements that are intended to make it a lot easier and more intuitive for customers in the building industry to use BricsCAD. Creating details has gotten much easier with a new panel instead of only command line input. The panel shows the steps involved with instructions. So select your reference solids, detail entities, and the section you want to work with. On the next step, you inspect and adjust the detail based on the preview shown in blue. And the final step is to create the detail, giving it a name, category, and tags. Then, when you head over to your detail panel, your new detail is ready and raring to go. You now also have more control over how new sheets are created when you add a new sheet. You now have two options: to create from scratch or to import layouts. Creating from scratch lets you specify numbering format, title, as well as templates of predefined sheet layouts in different sizes. Hitting the Add Sheet button adds your new sheet to the Sheet Set Manager. If you were to import layouts instead of creating a new sheet from scratch, you could add a drawing and see a preview of it in this window. You can specify the format of the sheet titles, and you can either have automatic numbering or specify your own. Once you're done, again, it's added to the Sheet Set Manager and it's ready to go. At Bricsys, we're always working on new ways to make your BIM workflows easier, quicker, and more efficient in a flexible and familiar CAD package with BIM capabilities.